Well, iron deficiency anemia is one of the most common forms of anemia all over the world. And of course, there are many underlying conditions responsible of iron deficiency, which must be recognized behind the treatment, because we must remove, of course, the cause of iron deficiency. However, all behind that, the iron deficiencies must be correct. And how can be correct? Giving iron. And the most common treatment is the use of oral iron, which can compensate the deficiency according to the severity. But of course, the oral treatment takes a long time. One of the major mistakes we make is to interrupt iron supplementation when there is just a mild improvement of hemoglobin and we don't care of iron, let's say, deposition, which is important as a reserve of iron. So we need to give iron long time in order to replete and regain the ferritin level, which represent the iron available in the body. Recently, new compounds have been made available, which can be given IV. The IV infusion of iron was always a bit scaring. I mean, physicians were not happy to give iron IV because of possibility of side effect, shocks, and so on. But that was the case with the previous molecules. With the most recent molecule, which are carboxymaltose iron, the risk of reaction is very, very low, and the results achieved with a single infusion of 500 milligram or two infusion is amazing. It can be consistent and improve the situation for months. So this is a really new approach which can be used in different settings, especially also in elderly patients who are not keen to take oral tablets. Maybe they have also to take many other drugs. So it can be actually an option for elderly, for patients with inflammatory anemia, for patients with inflammatory bowel disease, celiac, and so on.